So, where do we go from here? I've laid out three broad possibilities, right? There's a fourth one, but we're not going to talk too much about that. Right? The ones we're most interested in are the following three. First, we could agree with Gerges's argument. That is, we could say, actually, he's established his point. His argument is convincing. The government should not confer the status of marriage on same-sex unions. The second option is to say, no, his argument is not convincing, right? His argument and possibly his conclusion are incorrect, right? For certain reasons, okay? So in fact, he hasn't given us an adequately convincing reason why the government should give the status of marriage to only this particular subset of opposite sex unions. Now, the third possibility is to go a step farther and say, not only has he not proven his point, but he hasn't even given us a rational basis for thinking that the government should give recognition to what he calls marriage and only what he calls marriage. Right? And of course, that's a much stronger claim. Right? Now, as I've pointed out, if we take the position, right, that we ought to revise the nature of marriage but keep it limited, right, well, then we're going to have to affirm two claims, right? So what you could do on the discussion board is give arguments in support of one or both of those claims. Okay. I've also argued that if we want to go further and say that there is no rational basis for the traditional view, well, then we're going to have to affirm one of four claims. So if you want to take the argument in that direction and say there's not even a rational basis for the traditional view, then which of those four claims are you willing to affirm? Right? Spell that out and then give reasons for affirming that claim on Blackboard. Now, of course, you might think, look, I know it goes wrong somewhere, but I don't know where. And if so, well, we can't always have complete and total justification of everything we believe. Right? Doesn't give you much to post on Blackboard, right? But it's a possible position. So if that's as far as you want to go with things, well, give an argument on something different. Finally, right, if you decide that you agree with Gerges or you just want to argue for the sake of argument that what he's saying works, right, well, then you have to deal with the problem I talked about in the previous presentation. Right? That is, you have to argue that it is not that we can maintain his view on marriage, right? That we can accept his arguments for marriage and not come to the conclusion that we should restrict recognition to fertile couples, or more plausibly, to couples that are below a certain age. Okay. So that gives you a lot of options. Okay, so you have room to talk on the discussion board about why you think Gerges's argument works or doesn't work. Before you do that, I'd encourage you to watch the very brief video that I call Why We're Not Going to Debate About Religion. Right? One of the things that comes up is the fact that many people have religious objections to same-sex behavior, what Corvino calls homosexual behaviors, particularly to the government giving the legal status of marriage to same-sex unions. Right. We're not going to debate the merits of those, right, on religious grounds, for reasons that I'll explain in that video. Right? So I'll give a brief explanation of why we're not going to debate the religious side of the issue, right? And then we can go on to discuss, on the discussion board, to discuss in secular terms, right, whether Gerges's argument works or doesn't work.